Hi there, my name is Ole Lansmar. I work here at SmartBear Software in Stockholm, Sweden. I'm going to do a demo for you of the data-driven functional testing features in soapUI Pro. So if you're using the free version of soapUI, please head over to soapui.org and download the trial for soapUI Pro so you can hang along with the features. Have fun.
Okay, let's get started. So I have here a very simple soapUI project. I've imported a whistle for a service that we are hosting here internally at SmartBear. And this is a very simple inventory service where you can get items, add items, log in, log out, search, things like that. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do a data-driven test to check that some of expected items are actually in the inventory database. So to do that, let's just start by creating a test suite and a test case. And we'll start by adding the actual get item request, which is what we're going to be using to get the items that we want to validate. So the default request just contains this question mark for the ID. And of course, the response we're getting back is just an error because that's not what the service expects. So what we need to do here is start by adding a data source test step. So this is one of the cooler soapUI Pro features. Let's just add one of those. And I have my expected data set up in an Excel sheet. So I'm just gonna select the Excel data source up here. As you can see, there are a bunch of other possibilities, JDBC and files and directories and things like that. The file is here. And let's just have a quick look at that file so you see what the data I have here. So it's a very simple file. It just has five rows of IDs, a name, and a cost of my, well, not so imaginary smartphones. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a call to the inventory with the ID, and I'm going to check that the returned phone for each ID actually has this expected name and cost. So to do that, I need to add the same columns I had in my Excel sheet. I need to add those as properties here in my data source. So there was one ID, name, and cost. And just to test the data source, we can just run this a little bit, and you can see the rows I'm getting back here. And oh, I missed one thing here. As you can see, I'm actually getting the header row from the Excel sheet as well, so I need to change this .cell A2. So if I run that again, it's just going to give me the actual IDs. So great, the data source is set up. Let's go back to the request. So what I want to do is, instead of sending a question mark, obviously I want to use the ID that's been read up from the data source. So I'm using this right-click get data wizard, which allows me to select that ID property that I just created in the data source. And it's going to generate the required property expansion, which will be basically replaced with the corresponding ID when the request is being sent. So if I just send that request, as you can see here, we're actually getting a phone back from the inventory because the current ID is that of the last row that we read into the data source. But that's not all. I also wanted to validate that the actual cost and name of the phones I'm getting back is the same as in the Excel sheet. So for that, I'll use standard xpath assertions in soapUI. But in the free version, you have to create those manually. But in the pro version, there's a very nice wizard. So you can just right click, add assertion for content. And it's going to generate the whole xpath statement and expected result for you. Of course, here I don't want the expected result to be a fixed value. I want to get that from the data source, just as, like I did with the ID. So I'll just use the same get data wizard and save that. And the same thing for the phone. And this get data wizard is available in most, not all, but in most edit fields in Pro where you can use property expansions. Okay, great. So here, property expansion for name, and it selects the name from the response. I'll save that. You can see the assertions down here, and when I send the request, obviously the assertions will pass since it's all matching up now in my data source. So let's go back to the test case. And if I run this test just as it is, it's only going to send one request. But that's not what I intended. I intended to send one request for each row in the data source. So the final touch here is to add a data source loop test step after the request. Just move that down here. And the loop test step, what it does is it'll increment the data source to the next row. And if it has a next row, so if it's not at the end, you tell it to jump back to the request in our case. So it's going to basically loop you through the data source. And as long as it finds another row, it'll jump back to the get item request, which will be executed, and then the loop again until the data ends. So if I run this now, you can see in the log down here that it's actually ran these five requests. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And you can, in the log here, of course, double click any request, and you can see the actual request that was sent with this ID, for example. And this was the data we got back from the service. Great. So I have my data-driven test up and running. Before I end this, I'm just going to show you what happens if there's a mismatch in the data. So let's go back to the Excel sheet and change the price of one of the phones here. Save that and now run the test again. And now we can see that the test is actually failing here because it expects the old price, and the one I set it to was the new one. And this is not so unusual. And what you might want to happen here is not actually the test to stop, but to continue to run through all the rows in your data source. So there's an option for that. In the test case options dialog, it's called abort on error, and it's checked by default. So you can just uncheck that. And okay, like that. And we'll run the test again. And as you can see, now it's failed, but it still ran the remaining requests. And since there was one failed test step, it'll fail the entire test case at the end anyway. So that's it. It's really easy to get started with data-driven testing in soapUI Pro. Wish you good luck with that. Bye-bye.